Well, first of all, I thought I would just start with a little gift for you, because I know you're sensitive.
Oh, bless you. Thank you so much.
You can have that at your leisure.
God bless you.
All right. Welcome to England.
I'm a happy man. Thank you very much.
So my first question is, what sci-fi technology would you like to bring into real life if you could?
I would love transportation beaming. I mean,
oh, 100%.
Not only great for the environment, but just to cut down travel would be awesome.
Yeah. I second that, but also the Universal Translator.
Yes.
I mean, just
I feel like we've kind of almost got a version of that already with the iPhone, right?
It's not quite there, is it?
It's not far off it, though.
Yeah.
It'd be fun. It'd be fun to reprogram it as well, so it says nothing that's correct.
That's actually correct. <It's>
There's a... Yeah, there's a lot of punking possibilities.
Exactly.
In that.
If you could set up a teleport between
that scenario you just laid out. So in this scenario, you have a person who is speaking another language to another person and proposes marriage accidentally, and one person is frightened. Okay.
The translator is just.
I just wanted to lay out the mise en scène before.
How many kids shall we have?
Yeah. No.
25.
Exactly. If you could set up a teleport between one place and another, where would that be? Like your bed to Five Guys, or where would you choose?
I'm sorry?
Your teleport, your...
Our bed to Five Guys?
Yeah.
What?
Where, like, for me, I would do my bedroom straight to a Five Guys. That's where
what's a Five Guys?
It's like a burger place.
Oh!
No, not Five Guys!
Right,
Jesus!
You're like,
well, you
hey, whatever you're into, I mean, if you're into
guys,
that, that's
cool. I mean, that's cool.
No judgment.
I mean, that's fun.
Judging,
that's,
I mean, sounds good.
I mean, not
shaming.
That I'm in. I mean, are you asking?
That's the way you roll.
No, because I'm...
Good
listen.
Wow, I mean, impressive. I'm impressed.
Both of you guys' eyes were like...
Five, that's a lot of...
Really? Five?
Wow,
Jesus, English.
Wow.
Wow.
London calling. I'm sorry.
Transport anywhere. That's a great question.
Yeah, where would
you go? Because you want to be able to go more than one location, but
I'd love to visit all the spots away from my house that are tough to get to. To the pyramids. The
Santa
the rainforest.
Santa Monica, Malibu. Just anywhere on the west.
To my agents, it's just they're on the west side.
They're on
it's
the
really
west
tough
side,
to
it's
get.
Drag.
That's just lazy. That's what FaceTime's for.
The Starbucks.
So I've made
to the head of the line at Starbucks.
Yeah.
Yeah, skip the queue. Do you get to skip the queue actually, because you're like stars?
We don't roll like that.
Oh, that's a shame. Maybe.
Chris Pine does.
Oh.
Yeah. He throws hot coffee on people.
That's how he skips the queue.
That's how he skips the queue.
People just wave
scalding
out the way.
Hot coffee on children. You know?
Oh, he's harsh.
He's abusive.
It's hardcore. Just bumped into him in the corner, actually.
Did he throw hot coffee on you?
No, I think he looked a little bit weird because I looked like I was on set and I sort of just panicked and did that. But
oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. You mentioned the Five Guys thing. It's a conversation.
I like Five Guys. This is my little costume that I made this morning.
I love that costume.
Love it.
I'm putting
fantastic
my little arts and crafts.
You just made that this morning.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
Nail varnish and some safety pins. Did you have any say on your costumes in the movie? Did you get to...
No, I didn't. But I remember going into to Sonia, who was the head of wardrobe. And during Between the Two Films, a fan came up to me and said, please, can you put ranks on the women's costumes, because in the previous film they didn't have a rank on them. So I went to Sonia and I said, we are having ranks for the women,
well,
aren't we? And she was like, yes, definitely way ahead of you.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Do you remember on the first one,
there
was a discussion as to whether the pants were in the boots or out of the boots?
Yes, we did. We had an in-boots, out-of-boots conversation. Yeah.
I don't even recall where we ended up.
One in, one out. That's where I'd go.
It was in.
Were you talking about the Five Guys?
Oh my God!
I gotta stop.
This is gonna.
You guys are
gonna I have to stop. We just. I'm sorry.
We can't get that out of his head.
Six of us.
Yeah.
Cool. Amazing. So this is the second time that a Star Trek film and a Star Wars film has ever come out at the same time. Would you ever go to the dark side, or are you Trekkies for life?
I like the Star Trek films. Do you?
I do.
Good,
I like,
you're in
I
them.
Like, yeah.
I mean, it's Star Wars.
The Star Wars films. He's still... You really got him with the five guys.
Yeah.
It's going to take him a while to come back from that.
I like five.
Yeah, hey, I mean, I think JJ did an awesome, phenomenal job of rebooting the Star Wars franchise, and Simon's in it.
Mm.
Yeah, I don't like this whole Star Wars, Star Trek...
One love.
Opposition. One love. I dig it. Love. Yeah.
Cool. I've been looking at the sort of news, and there is a big hoo-ha going on at the moment about Sulu's little family.
Yeah.
And I saw the film, and I was, like, really impressed as well, because you have a daughter.
Yeah.
Amazing. And I was like, I'm a daughter, so I'm thanks for representing me in a movie. So that's great. So thanks. That's all I'm gonna say about that. Has anything ever gone wrong on set? Like, have you ever forgotten a line or
Yes, that happens every day. Every day. Sometimes the mistakes can end up in the film, like in this one. There's a scene where I'm trying to save Spock's life and I go up to this wrecked spaceship and I'm trying to pry a piece of the spaceship off a piece of metal, and in one of the takes I was, you know, ripping at it, and I actually did manage to pull off a piece of this set, and I went flying back into the water, and it was not supposed to be that way. But
that's the take they used.
One take.
Done.
Next.
I think Idris punched Chris by accident, and nice. So he got a black eye, and they rode with it.
They had to write the black eye into the film.
Yeah,
it's quite sexy. I quite like a black eye.
Yeah.
Okay. Black eye, not a black guy. This but I like
all,
black guy.
This
oh,
is
God.
All good information. All good information.
Hands down.
Oh my God, amazing.
For your own good, we have to finish.
I think I better. Then we go and like, gonna go and cool up. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.